Concerned, you are akin to nature as I am. Why did you not take up the blade to fight?
I do not think I would have the patience you do in battle.
Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. The Mints decided to start off the episode this time. I don't know. He didn't seem to be that patient. He turns into a friggin' werewolf and tears into people. I mean, that's pretty awesome.
A great oak might crush a building when it falls, but the sapling that seeps its roots through the foundation will stop the building in the first, lest the cellars leak and fungoids take the builders.
I don't think he's going to understand what you mean, because I don't even know what that's supposed to mean. Confused looks from all sides, but Minsk understands. You do? No one else does, but he does. Okay, so I've realized we missed a complete area going off the grove.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
So we can finish this quest with the animal trouble. And Faldorn, I remember as well. Well, one thing I realized watching back my video, the other one was Faldorn.
Treehara, I have a question for you. If a tree falls in a forest, does anybody care?
Faldorn we came across in the first Baldur's Gate, but I did not have her join the party. So, interesting to see what she's up to in this installment.
You've a nerve, Viconia. Anger and pain is your home, and a woeful, cold place it must be.
My brothers celebrate life, renewal, seasons, and the parliament of trees and the splendor of nature's bounty. Char and her ilk revere entropy, revenge, and darkness. Viconia, he says, you and I will never see eye to eye, and that... Hold on. Okay, sometimes I drop the desktop, but it's still running. Viconia, you and I will never see eye to eye, and that covenant should be respected and maintained. And to answer your question, yes, we do care. Viconia says, your kindred are a scourge, defending bees, trees, brooks, the dirt. It illustrates your inability to relate to anything with two legs and a language. Oh boy. A little vitriolic here. So. Right, back to the Druid Grove. Entrance to Druid Grove doesn't mean this. There's actual, like, you can go in here. I did not realize this.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Remember that other druid, that named druid, I forget his name. He ran off before we killed him. So he might still be around here. I don't know. I'm gonna take different ways. I don't like when we split up. Alright, wait here then. Talking to him. What are we traveling with? A mouse? A groundhog? He's coming with us. Alright. Alright, changed his mind. I think that's wise. Now we can't go through that. Yeah, I hate these outdoor areas that are mazes. Putting the brakes on here with our druid. I mean, not our druid. Our rogue friend. He wants to take off. But I think it's Cerned in his way. Yeah. Faerûn is faster than us, too. Curious. I never looked at his stats. Wisdom 18, wow. So she's the one behind this. Pretty interesting. And yeah, we can go in here. Okay. So, I don't know if we're gonna encounter evil in there.
Live by the sword! Stand back!
I can do justice!
But we'll put it on.
Manus potentis.
I don't know if we should, get hasted up. Well, we have one haste left. Alright. Actually, it's kind of a waste, but gonna rest. Because once that haste wears off, we're gonna be exhausted. And that's no good. And it sounds scary. Alright, so greater werewolf form. And now protection from evil. And haste. I always pass it. Oh, he's not protected? He didn't get in there? Oh, he did. Okay.
Minsk and Boo stand ready. See battle, Boo? Run, Boo, run!
What just happened? Like, what just hit us there? I don't know. Failed.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well. All the world is blind to my passing.
Can't go in there. Just this big pit. Little side chamber here. Can we just cross that? Okay. Okay, an adherent. And an adherent. We'd find down here, but
all the world is blind to my passing.
Like this pool of water. Interesting. Well, there's Faldorn. Two shadow druids and two adherents.
Fleet of foot and all that.
Maybe they can be reasoned with. I don't know. Only one way to find out.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
And it's not by throwing fireballs on them.
Well, what have we here? Some fool come to stop the righteous force of nature?
Laughable. Say what you must, and then we shall purge the earth of your filth. Alright, so we want to involve Cernd. He's the druid here. Although this is also true. Cernd would know what has changed here and why you rule as you do. Ah, Cernd. Come to investigate for the great druid, have you? You may tell him that his way is dead. We are the druids of shadow, and he can do nothing. He says, we shall see, Faldorn. You are not invulnerable just yet. Though I sense the filthy ritual you have performed, you drain from the land like some vile parasite.
I am stronger than ever with the aid of this grove. No harm can come to me here. Such bonding rituals are frowned upon as they draw energy from the earth itself, but the mother feeds me that I might fight for her.
Alright. Cernd, or I will fight you, all of you. We'll make a deal. Okay. I don't know anything about druid rituals. Okay, the rituals of ascension still rule here. Hopefully that's true. Cernd will challenge you for leadership. I will speak for myself. Faldorn, you perpetrate gross crimes here. You are unfit. I challenge you, and by the rites laid down ages ago, you cannot refuse.
What makes you think I would wish to refuse? I took this grove by force, and I shall keep it in the same manner.
Did you think I would retreat? Oh no, Cernd. This is your end. Prepare. Oh, they're in that pit. Okay, and he's in werewolf form. Cernd has... Well, attack. There's not much he can do other than that. All his stuff just disappears when he's a werewolf. It comes back after, I'm sure. I just want to see what it says. Sometimes you get interesting reveals in the text. Is that a done quest then? Oh. Cernd has challenged Faldorn in a duel to the death. The outcome of this battle will determine the fate of the druids and of trade meat as well. Alright, well.
With nature's
Interrupt. Casting failure. Yay. He is completely uninjured.
Thank you. Aid me. No.
Oh yes. That was easy. Cern says, the scourge has been purged. I can tell that the deed is done, for even now the land sighs with relief. This has been a great service to nature, and she shall not forget. Now will come rebuilding. Faldorn's invulnerability came with great cost, and the land bonded with her will suffer immeasurably. Is she dead now? Like, actually dead? Dead? It did say duel to the death. Verthan will serve as challenge master until the healing is done. His reverence for the land will not allow him to be corrupted if temporarily granted control. When the scars are healed, he can step aside. A new great druid will need to be chosen at some time. More turmoil ahead, but for now we can rest. What of you, Sapphire? You are likely off to travel. Would you mind my company? My day here is done, and I do love to see the land. Shall we join? Yeah, come. There is much to see. This for a while. Till the next person we bring back. Anoman, I think. A new season comes and growth is renewed. I am grateful for your indulgence. Master Verthan says, I stand as challenge master, and all that seek ascension in the druidic order can come to me. And for you, I must formalize our thanks. Go now, and worry no more about these woods and the druids who protect them. Remember to pick up any equipment that was dropped before the challenge. Oh. Faerûn. Where is it? That'd be a good mod. You click it up here and it brings you right to the entry. Faerûn has been defeated through the traditional druidic hierarchy. The land will recover in time, as will the citizens of Trademeet. Cernd is now free of his duty, and I welcome his continued presence in my party. That's another one? Let's just add to it? Keep adding to this. No, it says it. Oh no, this is a new one. Cernd has defeated Faerûn. The town of Trademeet will be safe now that the druids are back in their proper role. Balance is restored. Alright, so.
What is it that you ask?
So he. Okay. He can have this stuff, he just can't use it in the battle. That's, I guess, the rules of the battle. So these adherents and stuff have left? And there's nothing in here to do.
Fine.
I am the challenge master, and I ask of druids present if there are any that wish to make challenge. Our order is in disarray and in need of leadership. Do any here make claim to the challenge? Who is ready? Who shall be the figurehead for our grove and assume the title of great druid? There is none who need the challenge at this time. What if I have Cernd ask that? I guess he can't ask, because...
If it serves the greater good.
He is talking. But I'm like, well, you're a werewolf and can't speak.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Can he... Can I equip this stuff? What's this again? Shape changed, okay. But he can have this stuff. Okay. Can I put quivers? No? Okay. That's him? Man, that sounds scary as hell. Look, what the hell's coming?
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Okay. That would have been easy enough if I had known
you
it was
gather
there.
Your party before venturing forth.
If I had realized that was there, right?
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Back to Trademeet. Again. Alright. Humanize yourself.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
The way Yoshima always walks behind somebody and just continually bumps into them. Right, should we go talk to the mayor? is a foppish gentleman. Mayor's house over here. There we go.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Hi, merchant. Yes.
We are in your debt for whatever you did. I thank you, and trade meat thanks you.
Not only have the attacks stopped, but we have received reparations from the remaining druids. In addition, you solved our problem with the Jinn and restored prosperity to the merchants of my town, a problem I thought to be nearly insurmountable. You had a lot of experience points. I trust the guild mistress showered you with rewards, and if not, she should. I, for one, think it's high time to give you the hero's welcome you deserve. The guild mistress. Alright, we'll have to meet her for more rewards, I guess. Thank you very much. Oh, we have a meeting?
Citizens of Trademeet, we are gathered here today to honor the heroes of our small town.
Yeah. Dealing with the Trademeet genies. Led by the Lady Sapphire.
They have not only stopped the assault of nature upon us by removing the evil druid that had taken over our local grove, but have also spared us from the recent domination of the genies.
Increased by one. We're like seven now. We need some more points. But yeah, that's definitely an improvement. Step in the right direction.
You are once again free to walk the streets of Trademeet, and new caravans have already been hired to bring supplies to our local merchants.
What are you talking about? We've been walking the streets of Trademeet all this time.
It is good to know that even though we do not have our beloved Joaquin looking out for us, we still have people like this who we can turn to in a time of need. From this day forth, I declare that these companions be known as the heroes of Trademeet. Huh.
Their likenesses shall be displayed on the fountain forevermore. Wow, the heroes of Trademeet. That's something.
Bravo! Bravo!
Here, here!
You have saved us all!
Oh, yes. Most excellent work, hero.
She's gotta be different.
Indeed!
You will always be welcome here, no matter what your reputation might be elsewhere. May the gods smile on you for all you have done.
Greetings to you. I'm Lady Lilith Lorexel, the head of the noble family that founded this town long, long ago. I am pleased to make your acquaintance. It is pleasing to know that there are heroes of real metal here in Trademeet, ones with both courage and ability. As it so happens, I have need of such people.
Yeah. You have another quest for us, I guess?
Please. If you are interested in the reward for performing such a task, do come and speak to me at my mansion. I look forward to seeing you there.
I see that vicious harpy has already pounced upon you. Ignore whatever she says. She is a conniving witch and a liar.
He's like,
I am Lord Skarmay and Ali Bakar.
The what?
It is my family that founded Trademeet, not hers. So I greet you in the name of the town's premier family.
Okay.
No doubt Lady Lilith has asked you to perform a service for her. I happen to need the same service done. So I ask that you come to see me in my home so that we may discuss it further.
Huh. Ali Bakar and Loruxel or whatever. Alright, both of them need the same service. Done. The exact same service? Or do you need like one of the same item or something?
If you are foolish and work for the Loraxols, however, you will not be welcome in my home. Think carefully on this.
Huh. Alright, so we'll meet with him first. And then we'll meet with her, and then we'll do both quests. Now he leaves, okay. Anyone else?
I'm sorry they chose to involve you in their schemes. The Loraxels and the Alevacars are old and powerful families here, and they have been feuding for generations. Be careful in your dealings with them. That's all I can say. I have here a reward that the town merchants have gathered for you.
Don't forget to go and see the statues that have been conjured in your image. They're in the center of town at the fountain.
Surface dwellers can be so stupid.
That's the perfect wrap-up comment for this entire scene, I think, with those two. So what's it say? The dueling families of trade meet. During the reward ceremony held for me by Lord Logan, both Lady Lilith Loraxel and Lord Scarmine Alibakar approached me separately, offering me employment and warning me against the other. Actually, I'm not sure she said anything like that. I think only he did. If I am interested, I should go see one of them at their estate. Lord Logan warned me afterwards of their feuding, saying I should steer clear of them for my own good. I can't resist that, though. I gotta see what it's all about. And then... I solved the problem with the Tao Genies, pleasing Lord Logan greatly. He promised a hero's welcome and suggested I collect a reward from Guild Mistress Busya if I have not already. These people just leave us to our own devices.
Stand back for justice!
If there's anybody still around. Did we look in here?
Yoshimo is willing.
Probably. Yeah.
See, battle bow! Run, boy, run!
Do you have anything else to say before we go? Greetings again, Sapphire. Lady Lilith and Lord Scarmine are not annoying you over much, I hope. Again, I urge you to be cautious. Yeah, you're cautious.
Make way, villainy! Oh. Hero coming through!
You will always be welcome here. Perhaps Lord Logan will name you High Merchant so he can join his sister and Rhea Tavin. Stranger things have happened. I feel like checking in on everyone, just see what they might say.
Well met and welcome!
Not all the peasants, but definitely all the named people. Although some people are finding us first. Jenia says, please, my lady, may I speak to you? My name is Jenia, and I come to you on behalf of my son, Tyrus. He is very frightened, my lady. Too frightened to even leave our home. Please, you are such a hero of this town. I beg of you to come and speak to him, to see what has frightened him so, and perhaps help him. I guess he's possessed. You might need Constantine. I don't know about me. I will help him if I can. Where is he? Oh, thank the gods that you are so merciful. Tyrus is at our home, the one just north of the Alibakar estate. Please come as soon as you are able to. I so despair seeing him like this. Helping Tyrus and trade me. I've been approached by a woman named Jenia who claims that her son, Tyrus, desperately needs my help. If I am to help him, I should go to their house just north of the Alibakar estate. Alright. Well, we're heading that way anyway, ultimately. It was Roddy, I have to say. I'm told you're a hero. You don't look like a bleeding hero. Well, that's because we are currently not bleeding. He's a boy. My mom says you're going to be overrun by ogres soon. There's an army of them coming, she said. What's an ogre?
Hey,
Is that a halfling?
I'll trade you a few words, sure enough.
Everine's mercy, you're one of the heroes of the town. Pleased to meet you. Ah, Trade Meek is back to the bustling town it's supposed to be. I suppose you're the one to thank, hey? Let me just check around quick. Quickish. We can't go in there? Oh. Alan.
Bat kicking for goodness!
I think I read that before.
Well, if you wants to go strapping with this nab, you'll first have to give up the socket money.
Yeah, I read that.
I trust all is well.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Who are you?
Anything new? Have you seen many wonderful things in your travels, stranger? I hear the city of Athkatla is so huge it could hold 1 million people, and the streets there are littered with gold coins that the nobles just throw away.